Greetings. I welcome you to this course on Fundamentals of Automotive Systems. I'm sure that all of us are exposed to an automobile as part of our day-to-day life, and would be quite curious to understand, you know, what constitutes an automobile and how do various systems in an automobile work. So to learn some concepts associated with an automobile and its systems is the primary objective of this particular course. If you consider a typical automobile, an automobile consists of a powertrain, which is made up of a prime mover, like an internal combustion engine, along with a transmission that provides the power to drive the wheels. So in this course, we would start off by learning concepts regarding the internal combustion engine, how it works, how it is constituted, and how do we analyze internal combustion engines for their performance. And then we would learn how the engine is interfaced with the transmission to achieve vehicle drive. You know, that is, how do we design a transmission to meet certain vehicle performance requirements like maximum acceleration, maximum speed, and great climbing. So that would be followed up by a study of automotive brakes, where we would learn how the brake system is constituted, how it works, and then like how one could use the brake system to control the vehicle. And we would also learn about the automotive steering and suspension system, which are very critical systems as far as the so-called vehicle handling and also vehicle ride comfort is concerned. Then we would have a brief overview of electric powertrains, given the increasing application in road vehicles. We'll learn what are the different configurations of electric and hybrid electric vehicles, and we'll also learn how, you know, to analyze such powertrains to meet certain vehicle performance requirements. Finally, we would also look at the pneumatic tire, which is a very important component that transmits forces between the tire and the road surface. So while studying all these subsystems, a common theme in this particular course would be to learn the relevant material along three lines. The first direction would be to learn about the components which constitute a particular system. For example, we would learn what components are typically present in an internal combustion engine. The second line of learning would be towards how these components work together to achieve certain functions. For example, let's say if we are having a transmission, how different components of a transmission work together to transfer energy from the prime mover to the wheels. The third line of learning that would happen in this particular course is to apply concepts from basic engineering courses that we typically learn in the first or second year of undergraduate engineering programs, such as statics and dynamics, fluid mechanics, and thermodynamics, to develop simple models that can be used for analyzing these systems to gain a quantitative understanding of the performance of various systems. So in a nutshell, the course would involve learning about how each automotive system is constituted, how it operates, and how one could do a simple analysis to gain understanding. So this course is expected to provide a fundamental understanding of an automobile to a student or practitioner who is entering into the domain of automobile engineering. And the scope of this particular course would be mainly restricted to four-wheeled road vehicles. So that in essence is a broad overview of what one could expect to learn out of this course. And once again, I welcome you to join this course, and happy learning to you.